News update for Tuesday, June the 6th, 2017. All right. So anyway, I tell you, can you believe it's already June the 6th? Well, we have lots of things going on, as always. Not good, some good, some bad, but it's a lot more bad than good. But good, always, and I mean, it really seems like bad seems to be winning right now, but really, actually, good is winning. Because there's a lot more good in the world, just never gets talked about or reported. We will talk about it here. We're not going to get you all scared and doom and gloom in here. But we want to tell you some things that are going on. Today they have ordered all workers to evacuate the area where London Bridge is because they're saying it's under another attack. And it could happen at any time. Okay, now we don't know how credible that warning is, but they say it's coming from the same, from one of the people who they arrested. They actually warned that or said that. So we don't know how credible that is. They might have just said it because they got caught and they're mad as all get out. But the thing is, we have to take all threats seriously over there in London or anywhere in the world. But I don't agree with the Queen over there saying that we need to regulate the internet and say that everybody's a terrorist and everybody should have more surveillance because the fact that people say what they want because it's called freedom of speech. I don't think anybody is a terrorist. But if they go threatening to blow up presidents or blow up buildings or blow up buildings or places or kill people or say their name, like put a head on there of a president, you know, like our president, a bloody head of his, that was not funny, was not right, it was not cool. That can be considered hate or terrorism, form of terrorism there. So, you know, we have to be careful what we're putting out there online. You know, you might think you're a comedian, but now you're a commodian because now your career is gone, see? So you can't be doing stupid stuff like that because that was just plain D-U-M-P, dumb, or D-U-M-B. Some people might spell it both ways, dump or dumb. But the thing is, it was just really dumb to do that because you just ruined your career, basically. And now you may even face jail time because of putting that bloody head of Donald Trump on the false social media. So, you know, was it really worth it? Was it really smart? No. Was no on both accounts. So I want to say, don't do stupid stuff like that. You might not like Trump. You may not like Obama. You may not like it. You may not like me. I don't really care. But, you know, don't do stupid stuff because it can come back to haunt you. Get the black suits knocking at your door, you know? Hey, we're here. We need to come in. We need to confiscate all the stuff you have. We need to take you and we need to put you in lockup. You know, that's what you'll get. So don't be doing stupid stuff like that, okay? Because that could happen to you. Okay, and I don't believe that everybody that has an opinion that's different from the system or from the government or from anyone else, for the matter, should be locked up. But I do believe you should be careful what you say. I don't think the internet has to be taken apart or be sutured like a surgeon with all these government back doors and software in there. That's how come this virus got out, this WannaCry, because it was a dump that was one of those tools that the government had to stop predators or hackers on Windows. Since over 75% of all the world's computers are Windows or operating systems in there, or some version. There's not a virus that's aimed towards the 2000 system that just came out in this variation of the WannaCry crypto virus. What they do is they just go in there on, it's mainly affecting the Windows 2003 servers and 2003 operating systems. And that actually is out of operation or out of cycle of updates from Microsoft. So that will probably not get an update or a patch, but then again, you never know. Didn't think XP would get a patch, but for the WannaCry virus, it did get one. Ransomware virus, it did. They did patch it. So you never know. They did patch 2002 and 3, too. So they may do that again, because a lot of servers are still running that older operating system. So you need to update to a newer system. You know, I know you want to spend the money, but if you spent the money, you wouldn't have this problem like you're having right now. See, because you act dumb, that's why you get these problems, because you don't update, you know. So I'm going to try to save some money, but it's not really saving money when your whole system crashes. See? So that's why it's so important to update, okay? You know, a lot of people want to try to do the little short way around, but, you know, it's not, this stuff is out of date, so it's adequate. So you need to update, need to replace. Okay, I say that all the time, and they tell you that in computer class. You know, if you ever gone, if you paid attention, they always tell you to update. Like, replace your hardware and your software. You update regularly. Gotta make you more secure. Make you more safe. Yeah, yeah. Makes you more safe. Yeah, yeah. So, update. Get rid of that antiquated servers and antiquated operating computer systems. Oh, spend some money. Update. Change the hardware, software. Stop trying to be lazy, trying to be crazy. That's why you're gonna get hit with this vulnerability that's out right now. Update. That's all I can tell you. So that won't happen to you, okay? Whew, that was pretty good, huh? I mean, but you know, so many people here need to learn this stuff, man. I mean, I hate to talk like that, but, you know, a lot of people like to save money and cut corners, and this is not something you cut corners on. When it comes to cybersecurity, you need to make sure you keep that up. All right, let's get it on. Paris Agreement. Did you know Virginia? A lot of local area people have signed on to the Paris Agreement against what Donald J. Trump just signed an executive order to stop. Well, Virginia, New York, Pennsylvania, and about 9 other states or more have signed on to this Paris global carbon tax, business robbing, pilchering America, I should say, kind of plan is what they did, which is going to destroy America and destroy other countries who have also signed into it. All this is just filling a lot of pockets, like somebody said, and making every other nation that they do this to poor. Poorer than, say, Haiti. Because that's what America's going to be like after this goes into effect, and everybody's got to pay all this money and all these lawsuits come out, and it makes everybody poor as all get out. Because that's part of the Paris clean air. It's more than just clean air. It's an economic, it's a cultural, it's a business. It's all, a bunch of things all wrapped up in a pretty little paper, and of course it ain't so pretty when you look at all the details. So you need to read stuff instead of just saying, oh, we're going to just go on and sign on with it and turn our back against what President Trump just did to keep us from having to go under that horrible carbon tax and robbing and stabbing financial system of what they're trying to do with this global clean air initiative, which is really going to be what rapes America financially, politically, culturally, and economically. I mean, come on, where's your brains at? Get your head out of the toilet. You know, why would you sign for something like that, folks? That's so dumb. Dumb. You know, what are you all licking? Your own crap coming out your rear end? You must be, because you definitely got it wrong. Why would you want to rob your own people of resources and economic opportunity and growth? Why are we being punished when Japan should have this initiative and China should have this initiative and places certain places in Africa where they're really polluted should have this strict initiative? We've got some of the cleanest air here in most places in America. It's cleaner than most places in a lot of places in the world. So why would they want to put us under this extra strict initiative when Japan, places like Japan and China, can just pollute there and not put filters on their power plant facilities, when yet we got filters on ours and all we spew out is just steam and water? There's no radiation or nothing coming out there, and carbon maybe comes out, but carbon's what grows the plants, you dummies. You know, where you have, it's called a closed system. You heard it? When God created the world, it was called a closed ecosystem, which means it's supposed to grow and produce carbon monoxide so the plants will grow and put more oxygen in the air and therefore make the atmosphere thicker and more ozone would happen. You cut away the carbon, you strip away the atmosphere. Dumb, 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 dumb. You see, all this is all stupid stuff, okay? And you're so worried about, you know, trying to get rid of carbon, but, you know, carbon is in everything. You can't get rid of it. You reduce it, you lose everything on the earth. There's got to be a balance. When God made this planet, it was supposed to be of a balance. And all you guru, geeks, gay, whatever, weirdo, globalists want to come in here and screw it all up. God put it there for a reason. There's balance. God did it to establish balance, because as long as there's balance, and the atmosphere will flourish, the plants will grow, the animals will thrive, they won't die off like they're doing. Many fish die off, and strange animals are just killing over all over the world. You know, all over the place. You know, because there's not enough air. There's not enough food. There's not enough, you know, atmosphere. That's why they're dying. If you take away the atmosphere, it's going to kill everything on this planet. And eventually, it's going to kill all of us, including you globalists that keep rubbing your butt and having all your orgies and all your rituals of satanicism and all. It's going to kill you, too. The devil, even that won't protect you because you'll be dead as well, just like us. So why you take the atmosphere away, it's a closed ecosystem. That's the way God created it because it's by creation and design. It's supposed to be that way. Everything connects and everything works off of each other. Oxygen, you know, the trees, carbon dioxide gets in the air. The plants make oxygen, and that's what makes the atmosphere make more ozone, and that's what makes it get thicker. Okay, when you take away carbon, then it takes away all that. Okay, it's just 2 + 2 = 4, and, you know, you can't get other numbers. That's what it is, okay? And if you do the opposite, well, you're going to take all that away, and everything will just be, including you. Everything will be dead. You know, so that, if you want to strip away the carbon and lower it, because in the beginning when God created the world, carbon was up 50,000%. And then carbon's not a bad thing. It's a good thing. It's a product of life, in case you didn't know that. All things produce carbon. Even the ocean produces it at big, vast quantities of it. So, you know, we have to have carbon in the world for everything else to live, because everything kind of piggybacks off of it, you dummies. So get your heads out of your butt and realize what's really going on here. We got cancer up 10,000%. We got diabetes up about 30,000%. You know, we got all kinds. We got Alzheimer's, one out of every 650-some kids, you know, now. So, you know, not Alzheimer's, I mean autism, I'm sorry. And autism is even up at an all-time high. I bet I got it mixed up there, but I corrected myself. We got autism up about 50, you know, it's about 1 in 650-some kids. It used to be 1 out of every 1,500 kids. So, you know, just recently, it's showing one out of every 600 kids has it. It's gonna even double even in another 5 or 10 years. It's going to even cut that in half. So, you know, about 3 more years, it'll be 1 out of every 300. Some kids will have autism or will have Down syndrome. So you see what I'm saying? We got to stop thinking. There's something very wrong here. Polluting the air, polluting the water, polluting the food is not going to save the world or make you all elitist, globalist, crazy people thinking you're going to be machines and you're going to take over the world, because you're going to die too. Because when you kill us, Antichrist is going to come and kill you. And it's only going to be an Antichrist anyway in the end anyway, until the world ends anyway. Because God's going to come and finish him off, because that's what it says in the Bible. So, you know, keep thinking that you all, 120-some men, women, if there are any women among you, I don't really care. But the thing is, you need to stop thinking about your selfish reasons and start thinking about the world. I know there was nothing that went on good at the Bilderberg, turd meeting that went on last week. Nothing good came out of that whatsoever. You know, everybody's trying to expose the way on how to take down Trump, how to assassinate him, how to kill him. I mean, most of the globalists there want him dead. They want him assassinated. I think Donald Trump is doing a wonderful job. He may not be perfect, but he's doing a far better job than a lot of presidents we had, you know, since I've been on this earth. You know, I think he's better. I think he's better than Reagan. I think he's Washington 2.0, George Washington, that is, 2.0. I agree with Alex Jones on that point, because I believe I see that, you know, and you know, that's what I'm saying. We got to stop this, because we take away the carbon, it's going to destroy everything. I've always said this before, and it will, because carbon, it piggybacks off of everything else. That's the source of all life, carbon. Without it, everything is gone. So, you know, just think about these things. You know, intimate attack anytime, where the bridge happened in London. They talked about just the two or three days ago, they had an attack where a truck plowed into 30-some people. It injured about 30-some people and killed a couple. And now they're talking about another terrorist attack. When they arrested one of the suspects, there were three that were taken to custody. They actually confessed that there's another attack coming somewhere in that area, and they evacuated all the businesses in that area in London today, because of that attack. So, you know, what I'm saying is, if you let all these crazy people in that are Islamic, I'm going to say what it is. I don't care, because that's what it is. If you let these Islamic people in and you let them come in and you don't vet them, you don't check their background, that's what's going to happen here. It's what's happening in London, what's happening in the UK and all around the world. Because you let them in, you have no borders, and this is what you are taking and asking upon yourself. You know, that's why we need to close the borders and have security at the borders. That's why nations have borders. You know, that's what they taught me in history class. A nation is a nation when it has or surrounded by a border. That's why you have a border, so you don't let crazy people come in and rape your children or rape your parents or rape your brothers and sisters, because that's what's happening already some here in America. And what is really happening in the UK and also happening in London and everywhere else all this is going on. Because we're letting these people come in instead of checking them out. We should deport all these criminals out of here. We should have sweeps with all the mosques throughout the world, and if there's any terrorist or anybody, they should be deported back to where they came from and not allowed to return ever to this country. There should be 3-day, or not 3-day, but 90-day holds on visas on questionable people, and this should be implemented throughout the world. That's how we can keep this country safe, and, you know, and that's how we can keep these terrorist attacks on our cities and businesses and foundations here at home as well as around the world. You want to talk about solutions? That's solutions. You government, take this stuff, and you need to do this, because if we don't do this, our country is going to be destroyed from within, from these crazy Islamic fascist terrorist groups, because you all ain't doing nothing to stop it, because your bad policies are what you put into power, and that's why all this is happening. Let's get off our butt and change it and get these people out of here. If they're causing trouble, they need to go back where they came from. If they're peaceful and they can live here and integrate with us, then they can stay. But those people who want to cause trouble, they want to have all their little cliques and have all their little cells in our country and terrorist cells, we need to get them out of here. We need to vacuum, turn the vacuum cleaners on and get them out of here. Send them back where they came from. They can blow up all the people over there where they came from. This is in the news. Michael DeSilva. Keep it strong. Keep it true. Just a heads up, everyone. Take care. Top of the morning. Top of the moon to you. Top of the evening. Top of the day to you, depending on when you're listening. Take care.